Hi, I'm Diana Lee Inosanto.
And I'm Ron Balicki.
Today we're going to be going over Jun Fan Gung Fu, which is also sometimes known as Jeet Kune Do. And we are going to be concentrating actually on the kickboxing portion of this. But before we begin, I recommend strongly that you wear street shoes, preferably tennis shoes. When I always want to say Uncle Bruce, because growing up as a little girl, I knew him because he was one of my father's best friends, and he was also my father's instructor. But one of the things Dad always explained to me is that when he designed this art, he designed it for the streets. So I know probably some of you may be used to, you know, basically doing martial arts barefooted, but we do recommend very strongly that you wear tennis shoes.
You also want to add some training equipment, if possible. Focus mitts or bag gloves, some hand protection. Just train smart. You always want some padding. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to swing you around. Get ready for camera. We're going to go left lead. Now, traditionally, Jun Fan Gung Fu is taught right lead. If you were right-handed, they put the strong side forward. I'm left-handed. I like to go with my left hand. Nowadays, people cross-train so much left and right. Go your own favorite way. It's, you know, fine. Just get the techniques down.
We actually recommend you do train both sides, actually.
Yeah, you should be ambidextrous with this. Okay, so we're going to do entries. So at distance, Diana has to bridge the gap, meaning she wants to close that range and be able to attack me. So we're going to start at what I would consider maybe a safe range, thinking she can't reach me from here. But right now, she's going to bridge the gap, so she's going to close it. So we're going to start off. Now, on the previous program that we showed in trapping, BUG was the eye jab. So she's going to start off with an eye jab. Even though she can't reach me, she's got to be Houdini right now. She's got to make me believe that she's actually trying. If I did this from here, I went, ugh. She knows that in my heart, I'm not trying to touch her. What I do is I lean with the body. I throw everything. I make her believe that I am trying to touch her. That's what she's got to do with me.
So you're baiting the opponent.
You got to bait it. She's going to go, BUG. Then the Nao Tech, which is a round kick or a hook kick, we call in Jun Fan Gung Fu. It's different. All right, terminology is different to art. If you probably talk to a taekwondo person and said hook kick, they might think that it's something that kind of comes back on. With ours, it's more here. This is the Nao Tech, which they call in Jun Fan Gung Fu the hook kick. Okay.
But we'll use the mainstream
term. Okay, so we'll say round kick. So she goes eye jab to the round kick, and then she's going to cross, hook, cross, and then I'm just going to have her put a kick in. Doesn't matter if it's the front kick or the rear kick or the front kick, whatever. Wherever the idea is, wherever I sign the mitt, she should kick it. Okay, so again, go BUG, Nao Tech, cross, hook, cross, and just a single kick for now. Go back a little bit. Now, snap it off fast. Go. Now, we're just sticking with cross, hook, cross, because it's pretty simple for you. You can do any variation you want. She could go jab, hook, cross. She can go uppercut, cross, uppercut. It doesn't matter. Right now, just for teaching purposes, she's coming in with the cross, the hook, and the cross. Pretty simple, okay? So, eye jab, slowly. Now she gets that lean. Now watch, she slides, and then she kicks the Nao Tech, and then she's gonna go to the cross,
cross
hook, cross, kick. Now what this thing is really designed for is when I go like that, just a distraction. I go hap like that. If I can hurt her, you know, all that much better if you're fighting. But if I can go here and I distract, see, it opens the line, and I can come in with that cross. So when she goes, BUG Nao Tech, one, two, three, and kick. Do it again, please. All right, now really make me believe that you're eye jabbing. One, two, good. One, two, three, and kick. That's the first one that we want, so dead slow. BUG, Nao Tech, cross, hook, cross, Nao Tech, okay? Second one, she's gonna bait low. Now, what we say is we say chop choy gua choy or ping choy gua choy. Doesn't matter the hand. What it means is like a low punch, she goes low, and then she's gonna go high. She's baiting me again. This is what we call ABD, attack by draw. She goes one, two. Now, you don't have to throw the full punch. Throw a full punch from low. I know it's not gonna touch me. But she baits low and then goes high. You don't like throw a half punch.
The intention is to add an element of surprise in this.
Okay, so ready?
Yes.
Low, high, kick.
Kick.
Cross.
Cross.
Hook, cross, round kick. Okay, do it again. Low, high. One, two, three. And the kick goes in, okay? All right, low, high. Low, high. Good. All right, so you fake low, go high, kick, cross, hook, cross, kick. Pop that off a couple times for him. Do that again. Good. One more time. Good. So she fake low, goes high, kicks, cross, hook, cross, and the kick comes in. Okay? So now, the third one is we kind of join the two. So she's going to go high, and when she goes high, picture I go back. So she needs to gain more ground. So she fakes low, then goes back high, then the kick, then the cross, cross. Hook, cross, and the kick. Shh. So this is what we call, I'm going to give you terminology now. Biuji, chop choy guat choy.
It's an eye jab.
There, she goes back high to the kick. Cross, hook, cross, and a kick. Now, all these are entries. I use this all the time in sparring. Whenever I'm sparring people, I go like that, and it gets me into where I can get into that close range. Okay? So,
going go. Slow. Again, going high.
High, low.
Low,
high, kick.
Kick.
One, two, three, kick. Okay?
Again, have speed.
High, low, high.
Getting that kick. Early surprise.
One, two, three. Kick. Now you talk to your partner. Some people don't like to get kicked. They're not used to it. They're like, hey, you're hurting me. You can always train it this way. If she goes high, low, high, and I could sign it here. And then we can go one, two, three, sign it here. Some people literally will do this. Go high, low, high. They'll sign one, two, three, and then they have them kick them in the rear end. Doesn't matter. It's whatever makes you comfortable. Okay? So you to go high, low, high, kick. One, two, three. Kick. She could go on me also. I should have told her that. Do it on me.
Okay.
All right. High, low, high. Kick. One, two, three. Kick. She just puts it on me. It doesn't matter. Whatever your comfort level is at and whatever you want to do. If you're getting ready for a fight, sometimes you might want to get that feel instead of always using a mitt. Me being like the teacher. So I'm also being taught. I'm taught. You go BG. Chop choy, guat choy. Now tech. Cross, hook, cross, and now tech. All right, so one more time at speed. Good, first one, BG now tech, cross, hook, cross. Second one, low, high. Third one, high, low, high. Kick, one, two, three, kick. Okay, that's our entries, our basic entries in Jun Fan Gung Fu. Okay, so now we're gonna still go with the entries, but we're gonna go from a sidekick counter into our entry. So right now, if I were to sidekick Diana, obviously it depends on how much pressure I'm coming in as to what she'll do with that sidekick. So right now, we're gonna start off with ha-pak. Ha means low, and pak, if you watch our other program, meant slap. So she's gonna come in with a low slap. Now, the low slap, if you're a basketball fan, I want you to think of like when you watch guys throw a free throw, they'll sit at the line and they'll dribble and they'll go like that. It looks stupid with these mitts on, but you dribble it and then they'll throw it. That's how I want the eye jab thrown from there for our first entry. So we are gonna go ha-pak in directly to the eye. So there'll be no stop. She will go right directly into it. Ha-pak to the eye jab, do you see it? So it's almost like a pinball, like it ricochets off something. As soon as the slap touches, it goes right into the eye jab. All right, so we go here, right there. Now do the whole thing. Okay, so the first one we're gonna go into, she's gonna go ha-pak, and then she will come with the eye jab with no stopping. So she goes ha-pak, eye jab, then the now tech. Do you see what she went into? So one more time, ha-pak, now tech, there it goes. One more time before we go into the punching. All right, ha-pak, BG now tech, there it is. Now. Let's go with the hitting. One, two, three, kick. Just like you did before. All right, so you're gonna go slowly. Ha-pak, Byuji, now tech, cross, hook, cross, and kick.
Working
that was my first option. Or she can go ha-pak, then she could go low, high, to the kick. One, two, three, and Okay, or she can go hop hock and then BUG chop choy gua choy now tech like I've taught you. One, high low high kick. One, two, three, and the kick. Okay, so all this just stems just from her doing the slap and into it. The basic theme is after she slaps, she goes directly to it. Or if I'm out of range, she might fake low, then go high, just to distract me to let her in a little further. Right. So again, hop hop, BUG, now attack. Go.
Hop hop, BUG, now cross, hook, cross, round kick.
Good. Now she's gonna go low high with it.
Low high, round kick, cross, hook, cross.
Good. That's it. So that's the three that I want you to do with the hop hop. Now, the next one that we're gonna do is called Jeet Q. Not GQ like the magazine, but Jeet, like Jeet Kune Do. It means intercept. Q means bridge. So right now, she's gonna pretend her forearm is a shock absorber. So if I were to come in, if there's a lot of pressure, she will bounce back off it. It will collapse and the body will spring away.
Right.
So when we're here, if I come in, she just goes off it. If I come in, one more time, please.
Sure.
If I go in with just a little bit of pressure, she just kind of doesn't move much. If I really jam that thing, whoosh, she just really backs off me. Okay? So we're gonna go GQ, BUG now tech, cross hook, cross,
kick.
And the now tech. Okay?
And changing the prefix.
See, or there, she goes low. Sorry, let's do that again.
Go ahead.
Low high.
Low high.
Okay. All right, next one there. Now she goes low high, kick. One, two, three. Now tech. Or the third one.
Right.
Here, high, low, high, and the now tech. So now, this is called Jeet Kune. So she side kicked me. Side kick, please. I just kind of put that up. It's just my shock absorber. One more time. So I just go there. Then I just come back in, and then I go. All right, so just like a little shock absorber. All right, that's the second one that I want out of you. So one more time.
Which one?
Jeet Kune? Now, first one. All right.
Absorb the kick. BUG. Round kick, cross, hook, cross, round kick. Again, absorb, and then I go low, high, round kick, cross, hook, cross, and I kick. Last one, absorb the kick, fake high, low, high, round kick, cross, hook, cross, round kick.
Okay, so that's basically the second part of our series, and it's what they call Jeet Kune. So just think of a shock absorber. This hand is there, it's just gonna take the brunt of all the energy and spring back off. Okay, the last entry I want you to do is Jik Tech off the Jeet Kune. I'm confusing you, right? All right, all this terminology. Let me explain it to you in a layman's term. When I sidekick Diana, just do the Jeet Kune. As I kick, now if I kick hard, she would rock back a little bit on this one. So let me do this again to you. So I come in and she rocks back. Now, as she rocks back, I want her foot to come up, guess where? Okay, the groin. Now, it's a good idea to have a cup. I'm breaking the rule. I don't have one right now, but I have my trusty focus.
Boy, is he breaking the rule.
So,
but get a cup.
Yeah, get a cup. Okay.
Please.
So when I go, it's going to go, I go in with Juk Tech, which is a side kick. She is going to Jeet Kune countering with Jik Tech. All right, so past all this terminology, she's going to rock back and front toe kick up. Okay, so I go here, and then she comes up. That was it. Good idea, cover. I'll tell you, even if I'm wearing a cup, I still have a habit of doing that when I do this technique. Okay, just a good idea. So one, there, that's it. And then she's gonna come back.
Cross.
One, two, three, kick. So you notice she went directly to it. Now, well, let me explain why. One, if she were to kick it, and if she were to get the groin, a lot of times it roots here. You go, oh, you're right there. She doesn't have to go in with the BOG now tech all the time. So this one, when we go here, one, two, three, kick. Okay, so if she got the groin, a lot of times you kind of, whoop, you know, every guy gets a little scared. You know what I'm talking about. You've been there. Okay, so when we go here, one, two, three, now tech. Okay, you got that. That's the first one. Now, let's say she didn't stun me. She didn't get it good. Okay, so when we go here, I go away. BUG now tech.
Then we're back into this.
That's it. Or
closing the distance. Go ahead again.
With the kick, sorry.
Again.
Or with the kick.
Low BUG. High.
That's it. Or the third one. That's
it. And then
it.
Faking high, low, high, round kick, cross, hook, cross,
that's
round
it.
Kick.
Which is really our fourth one for this series, because obviously if she kicks me in the groin, like I said, and I stay there, the first one is she just goes right for it. Okay, the second would be the eye jab, which we did. Then the third one would be the low to high to the kick, and then the high, low, high to the kick, countering with a cross, a hook, a cross, and end it with a round kick. So let's do all four one last time.
Okay.
Okay, right now, whoop, she gets a kick, I stay there. One,
cross,
two, three.
Cross.
That's it. Next one.
It doesn't score, and there's distance. Eugene, round, and I'll check. Cross, hook, cross, kick.
Third one.
Again, low, high, round kick, cross, hook, cross, round kick.
Last one.
Again, making high, low, high, round kick.
So that is our sidekick counters, and then we enter with Byuji or Chop Choy Gua Choy, or Byuji Chop Choy Gua Choy, now tech. Okay, I know the terminology is rough, but just rewind and watch again. Okay, so now we got the focus mitts out of the way. We're gonna kind of put it back and forth a little bit with just gloves on. I'm gonna bring Joe in this time. All right, Joey. All right, we're gonna start off with, I'm just gonna break it into a couple pieces, then we'll kind of join it together. I'm gonna do the sidekick like Diana and I did. He is, actually, Joe, you do the sidekick to me. All right, when he comes in with the sidekick, I'm gonna hop hock. All right, so one more time, go back a little bit, please. All right, come in. Hop hock, BG, now tech. One, two, three. All right. We already did this with the focus mitts, now we're doing it with gloves. But this time we're gonna add to it. Remember what we did in our previous program when we had the focus mitts. Joe went cross across, one, two, three, then lop, hook, cross, hook. Remember that. We're gonna add it to this just to kind of progress it along a little bit further. So when he sidekicks, hop hock, BUG, now tech, cross, hook, cross. Now I lops out. And I gua choy, which is the back fist. Then I'm gonna hook, cross, hook, and I will round kick right now. Okay? I'm just gonna do a lead leg round kick, either at his leg or his body, depending on whatever I see open or whatever I care to do. It's whatever I want. All right, so again, he comes in. Hop hock, BUG, now tech. Cross, hook, cross. As soon as I feel that, I'm gonna pull and hit. Hook, cross, hook, and I end it with a round kick. Okay, let me do it again. That's it. Okay? Slowly. Hop hock BUG now tech. Cross, hook, cross lop sao, hook, cross, hook, and the round kick comes out. Okay? One more time. And I put the round kick in. He's just staying there right now for drill sake. Otherwise, I would have him counter me, which we'll get to eventually. So last time, all right, when he goes, I can go here also, put up high please. I can also use the GQ. So when he goes, GQ, BUG now tech, one, two, three, lops out, hook, cross, hook, and I put the round kick in. Okay, so that's the first half that I want you to do. You should do it back and forth. Get used to it. You don't want to always want to play the one role. Have your partner try it out, and then when you join the drills, pick a side. One side does it for a while, then swap it over. Okay, so now you're halfway there in the drill. The second half is the counter to the round kick. I can round kick low or high, which I already said. So when we do this, if I go high, I want him to shoulder roll, and it's gonna set Joe up right for the hook. Okay, so do it one more time. Whoop, he hooks me, do you see it? So one more time. One, I hook, or he hooks, cross, and then hook. One more time. One, one, two, three, and then he would sidekick me if I did nothing. But we're gonna add more to it, so I shouldn't have even said that to you. But I should have. You need to know that if nothing else comes, round kick, sidekick, or just get a distance between you and that guy. Okay, so now, again, round kick. If I went low, he's still gonna shoulder roll. You don't wanna stay there, don't shoulder roll. It's hard to take that. It's gonna, a couple of those, you're gonna kind of be walking and limping a little bit. I'm gonna flatten the tire. All right, so if you kind of roll with it, you heard the term roll with the punches, the same thing, kind of just move out of the way. It's gonna take it on the back, it's a little more durable. So one, then he comes back, hook, cross, hook. Now I can bob and weave, which I did poorly. Let me do that again. There, one, two, bob and weave. That's what I want you to do on this side. I know this is a lot, but this is more of an advanced program that we're giving you now. So again, one, one, two, bob and weave. And now I'm gonna cross. When I cross, This I haven't taught you yet. This is called Wampak Byuji. Now let me spin you around this way. When I cross, this parry's just parried. Right there. You see it? So I'm going right for his face. I'm leaving this hand down just so you could see. It's bad form, but right there. Now he's gonna add the eye jab to it, but don't eye jab your partner. All right, right there, see it? That's it, right here. You see where it's going? Okay, actually I did show you this in the last program. You should know the Wampak Byuji. Okay, so one, right there. Okay, so again, when I round kick, hook, cross, I bob and weave. Wampak Byuji, cross, hook, cross, and he's gonna just side kick for drill's sake. Okay, one more time. Round kick, hook, cross, hook. Let me do that again. Round kick, hook, cross, bob and weave. Wampak Byuji, cross, hook, cross, side kick. Back up just to hear more. Okay, right here. One, two, bob, weave. One, two, three. And that's it. It's okay. It's okay. Let's do it again. Ready? Go. That's it. Okay, that's the second half of our drill. Slowly, I round kick, hook, cross, bob and weave. Wampak Byuji, cross, hook, cross, side kick. You got it? Round kick low, one, two, three. Wampak Byuji, cross, hook, cross. That's it. Okay, that's the second half of our drill. So very slowly, first half, when he came in at me with a side kick, I can Hapak Byuji, now tech, cross, hook, cross, lopsow, hook, cross, hook. I round kick. Don't counter yet. That's the end of the first half. Okay, second one, Joe's turn. Round kick, hook, cross, bob weave. Wampak the cross, one, two, three, side kick. That's the end of the second half. Okay, so now Joey's got his side, I've got my side. So in the drill, when he comes, I do the Hapak Byuji, now tech, cross, hook, cross. We go lopsow, hook, cross, hook, and I'm just gonna lay the kick in. He will shoulder roll, come back, hook, cross, I bob and weave. When I punch back, Wampak Byuji. Cross, hook, cross, side kick. I do the Hapak Byuji. One, two, three, lopsow, hook, cross, hook, round kick, hook, cross, bob, weave, Wampak Byuji, cross, hook, cross, and side kick. So what we do is we just created a back and forth drill. We call it like a ping pong drill. So when I've trained under Dan Inosanto, what he would teach me is like just counter recounter drills. This I kind of put together for myself, but it's not my material, it's all his material. Or it was Bruce Lee's material before him, but it's just what was handed down to me. So again, when we go, it doesn't matter who starts off. If I start off, he shoulder rolls, one, two, bob, weave. When I cross, one, two, three, I stop it. One, two, lopsow, hook, cross, hook, he shoulder, one, two, bob, weave, wampak, one, two, three, hapak. So we just go back and forth. That's it. That's the drill pretty much. You could just ping pong back and forth. The main thing that you want to do is build cadence and rapport. It's not about speed. Actually, when we train this, it's actually about like something about this speed. Just go here, and we just play back and forth with it. Like I said, it's easy to mask mistakes with speed. So if you slow down, you'll get the right technique going. In closing with this section, what you want to do is you want to start off really slow. The main thing is he knows for this drill, he's got a shoulder roll. If he faces it, face the kick. If he faces it, he's gonna have to come back with a cross. That's a different drill. We'll get to that some other time. Right now, shoulder roll. Then right there, I bob weave. I don't just have to bob weave either. If he goes one, hook, cross, I could sway back and go. You see it? There's probably a million other things I could do, but right now we're isolating it to when he hooks, cross, I'm just coming in, getting a bob and weave, and then he comes back with the wampak byuji. Then he will come back with the cross, the hook, the cross, and side kick for drill's sake. Okay, so that's the end of this section of counter and recounter, or ping pong. All right, now that we have this ping pong drill back and forth, now I'm just gonna add a takedown to it. So what I'm gonna do is isolate it. I'm gonna take it out of the ping pong just to show you what it is. But if Joe comes in and I do the hop hock, BUG, now tech, cross, hook, cross, I hit with the lop sao. If he blocks it, that's fine. If he doesn't block it, that's fine. The point is here. This is what we call a figure four. If you look right here, I don't know if the camera could come in there. It looks like a number four. So we go to the figure four, I drop it, I take down, and then I go into a wrist lock, okay? So one more time. So he goes hop hock, BUG now tech, cross hook, cross lop sao right there, and I just dump him right here, and I'll look at, I grab the wrist, grab my bicep, and I impact it up into my chest. All right, that's the figure four locking. Let me do it again slowly. In fact, let's switch sides. Okay, he goes hop hock, BUG now tech, cross hook, cross lop sao, I hit. Then I just grab, I sit down, and then I go into the figure four locking right here. Okay, again, this side. Hop hock, BUG now tech, cross hook, cross, and I lop sao. All right, after I lop sao, look where my arm's at. I just leave it right here. Pick up his arm, grab my own forearm, turn, just drop. And then I grab into the lock, okay? That's the first one that I want you to have, is figure four locking. Last time, go. Hop hock, BUG now tech, cross, hook, cross, lop sao. I just grab it, secure it to me. He becomes part of me. Then I grab on, go onto the wrist, and I put the lock on. Okay, now we're gonna go on Joey's side of it. He round kicks, I shoulder roll it. All right, put it on me a little, please. So, whoop, right there. So if I shoulder roll it, I turn in case it does come down. It's catching me more in the back. I don't like taking him at all. Usually if he round kicks, I usually kick the support leg. You could do that later. Let's just leave it as the shoulder roll for right now. So when he round kicks, here, I come back, hook, cross. He bob and weaves. When he comes back, right there. So I go cross, hook. When I throw the cross, this is called jiao sao. I've already taught that to you in a different program as it comes right here, okay? Let's say I don't fool him, or actually let me explain the jiao sao just in case you haven't seen the first series. When I come in, one, if he blocks it, I'm dropping his hand, bad form, but it's just to show you. I loop around and that will hit right here. But there are times I don't fool him, he blocks it. We're gonna go on that premise right now. Ideal, in an ideal world, he's fooled and I win. I like that world, okay? But if it doesn't work and he blocks it, that's what we're gonna go off of. So let's do this whole thing one more time. Round kick, and I go hook, cross, hook. He bob weave, wampak byuji. Cross, hook. When I cross, I jiao sao. So that running hand runs out. So now I'm gonna pull, and then I'm gonna throw it back that way. The reason I do that is sometimes when I pull, he pulls back. I let it go. Look where my shoulder goes. I just slip underneath his armpit. Do it one more time. So as I cross and I jiao, I pull it. When he pulls back, I just go right here. Now I press my my head or my ear into the side of his body. The reason why is if I go here, if he tries to spin out of it, I could get clipped with an elbow. So you wanna make sure that you stick to the side of his body. Swing out, it's a little bit harder for him. He's kind of stuck to me. I'm stuck on you, Joe. Okay, all right, so one more time. So he round kicks. Here, I go hook, cross, hook. Wampak byuji, cross hook, cross jiao sao. So I pull, he pulls back, I slip under. Look at my hand, I take it and I turn it, thumb down. Put it right to his leg and I'm gonna press and then drive him into the mat. Now look at my shoulder, it's still stuck to him. Now, if I didn't like him, I would punch through, but since I like him, I will put my hand through. I hook, come over, and I go into a single leg arm bar. See, the problem is a lot of jiu-jitsu guys and NHB guys, they don't like the single leg because roll out, Joe. The guy could roll out. Do you see it? Go back. Okay. So what I like to do is as he goes to roll out, I just lift the head. Go, roll out. See, it kind of stops that. Okay, so he's gonna go round kick, shoulder roll, one, two, bob weave, one pak bilji, cross hook, joust, I'll pull, he pulls back, I come in, I press it down, I put my hand on the face, step over, and arm bar. Let me go slow with that. Spin around the other side. Start back here so I can walk you back a little. Round kick, shoulder roll, one, two, bob weave, one pak, cross hook, go right here, joust out. He blocks it. I pull. He pulls back. I let it go. Stick to him. Press on the leg. Straight down. Follow it. Okay? Hand comes over. Up. Arm bar. Hold the head if you need to hold it. Round kick. Shoulder. Cross. Hook. Bob weave. Wampak bilji. Cross. Hook. Go right in to the joust out. The joust out hits in circles. If you didn't block it, I would just get that and continue on, discard all the other stuff that I was going into. But I go right here. I pull. If I feel him pull back, stick to him. Put your hand here. Can you see that? Now all I think about is, see where that sentry is, that Y? I think of pushing right down to it. Collapse him straight to the ground. Push on the face, step over. Armbar. Okay. So that's the first one that I want from what we call the joust house series. Okay, so now I took him down on the right side. I want to transfer it and take him down on the left side. This is not something that I choose. Actually, my opponent is the one who dictates which side is going to be taken down. I'll explain that in a second. So when we go, if he round kicks and I shoulder roll, cross, hook, he bob and weaves, I do the wampak, cross, hook, cross, and I joust out. If I pull and he doesn't pull back, I don't want to move him back. It doesn't make sense. So this is where he dictates what I do. I will go to this side. I'm going to move you here. So you press straight down on this side. Follow it down. Your armpit or your shoulder should stick in his armpit. Now I hook. The hand presses. Come over and then right to the armbar. Let me explain this. Scoot back a little bit so we can get you in. If I get the armbar, I'm going to explain something else to you. I like doing it at a 45 degree angle. I don't really want to be 90. Okay, part of the reason why, I'll explain that to you. If I'm here, and if I step over, look at this big gap. Even if I'm here, swing your head out, Joe. Get your head out. He could swing out. Now go back. If I go to 45, look at where my knee goes, and I get to lay back. Look at how tight it is all the way through it. So that I crimp it really well, and then I can pull the armbar on. Okay, see, now if Joe goes to roll out, see it, we got that danger again. So when I'm here, I usually, if I have the arm secure, I usually put the hand here just to make sure that he can't go anywhere. And then that way I get my crimp in and I get the arm held and put the arm bar on. He's stuck there. Okay, so one more time. Round kick, shoulder roll, hook, cross, bob weave, wampak bilji, cross, hook, joust. I swing, but it doesn't come back. I come right in. Shoulder sticks. Can you see that? The shoulder sticks right in the armpit. Okay. Press straight down. Collapse him to the ground. Hook. Press down or punch down. Come up. 45. See how it crimps in? Arm bars on. I can hold the head if I choose to do so. Okay. So that's taking the from the joust, bringing him down and going actually to his left side this time. Okay, so now there's a couple other things I'd like you to know from the joust, the running hand. Okay, if he round kicks, I shoulder roll, hook, cross, bob and weave, wampak bilji, cross, hook. When I go here and I joust, what I do is I pull it down, they scoop it out, and they hit that shoulder. So what they'll do is they hook the neck right here. So let me do that one more time. Round kick. So here, hook, cross, bob, weave, wampak, one, two, goes around, pull and hit the shoulder, and then they just step in. This is the single leg reap. I pull the arm in, and I take it right down here. Then they step over, and they're back into the arm bar, holding the head again. Okay? switch sides, let's do that. So he round kicks. One, two, bob weave, wampak, cross hook, jow, pull, hit, take it in, sweep it up. You see it? Then I just step right over, and then I go to the arm bar. Let me explain it slowly. Okay, so he round kicks. You got this. You got this. You got this. He bob weaves. You should have all this stuff. One, two, right here. So I pull and hook it out, hit the shoulder. I step in. See, I hook the neck, and it's just a reaping throw. I kick back and lift the leg. Okay? Then I step over and armbar. I can hold the head if I think he's going to run out. One more time. Round kick. One, two, bob weave, wampak, cross, hook, go around, pull, hit the shoulder, step in, step over, and right there. That's the single leg takedown, or single leg reap. Okay, so now we're gonna go into the last one in the Jiao Sao series. So when he comes in, actually he could come with the round kick or the side kick. If he came in with the side kick, hapak, BUG Nao Tech. One, two, when I go here, I could do the Jiao Sao right off there also. So I kept showing you off the round kick. I wanna let you know that we do it off the side kick too. So right now I pull it down, I hit the shoulder. So last time we single leg reaped. But if he survives that, I step. I just tuck the head, and then that gives me the arm bar. Let me do it again. Switch sides, Joe. Okay, so when he comes in, hapak, BUG, Nao Tech, cross, hook. So instead of doing the lopsaw, I'm just gonna jiao sao. So when I pull, hit that shoulder, I step in, you see it? I reap up. If he survives, I step. Now see how I grab the head? I just kind of tuck it right under there. Step over, sit back, or hold that and sit back. Okay, one more time. So he comes in, pop, BUG Nao Tech. One, two, right here, pull, hit it. I single leg reap, he survives, I step over, tuck the head, and arm bar. Actually, I am gonna do it another time. I wanna do it slow for you. I'm gonna do it really slow. All right, so he comes in. One, two, three, one, two, I go around. Pull, hit it. Step in, kick that out. It doesn't work or it fails, I step right through. See how I grab the head? I keep the head. Step in, lay back with the arm bar. Okay, that was the Jiao Sao series. Okay, that's it. I hope you liked it. I hope you got something out of it. Remember, use mitts. It's a really awesome training device.
And a cup also works too.
Yeah,
make sure.
A cup.
Please.
Sentry sells all that stuff. Mitts, gloves, get hand protection. It's just a good idea. You know, you don't damage your hands too much, and you can bring it up that notch without blasting your partner. You can really
right.
lay into this.
And take your time with the material, really. Just take your time with it. Learn to digest it and ingrain it into your muscle memory. Again, as we always talk about, be patient with yourself. You don't have to blast. You don't have to muscle anything. Right now, just get down the patterns, the motions that we're trying to teach you, and then you'll find that it becomes second nature.
What I've found out, it's really easy to hide your mistakes with speed. So sometimes slow down and you can really, really refine yourself and make it more crisp. And then when you do speed up, it's going to be all that much better.
All right. Well, thank you very much.